Good morning. I want to welcome everyone to this special day here at Christ United Methodist Church. Those of you that are here or on whatever streaming platform you may be watching from at home. This is a very special day. About June 13th, the week of June 13th, we took a group of 30 to 35 youth and adults to Ironton, Ohio, to be the hands and feet of God in that community. Up here you will see a sampling of that group, certainly not the 35 that we took, but it's certainly a good group. And it's the combined group of Summit Station United Methodist Church and our own Christ United Methodist Church. So we are certainly glad that you are here to share in this celebration of that particular week. We do have a couple of items that we need to check on. If you are here in the congregation, we would ask that you fill out the Connect card with your name and any other pertinent information that you need the office to get. So we would ask that you do that and put it in the offering plate as you leave the sanctuary. I do believe we have a few announcements. And next week is a very special day. We are going to begin our children's and youth Sunday schools again. COVID's taken its toll on many of the things going on in the church. We are glad to get that one back up and running. That will be at 9 o'clock prior to the service. So again, youth and children's Sunday school next week. Also on July 17th and August 21st, we will have our two remaining summer community cookouts. They are open to the whole community, and everyone in the congregation is also welcome. So if you feel like having a cookout those two evenings, feel free to come over to the church here, and we will have that food for you. And finally, newsletter deadline has been changed a little bit. They need it by Monday, July 26th by noon. So if you have an item or an article to put in the newsletter, we would ask that you put that or get that to Trista by the 26th. And that seems to be it. Again, we are so glad that you are here. And as you are able, if you would stand and join us in unison for the call to worship, which is in your bulletin, and it is also on the screen. The church is not a building. The church is not a steeple. The church is not a resting place. The church is a people. I am the church. You are the church. We are the church together. All who follow Jesus all around the world, yes, we're the church together. If you'll remain standing and join us in the opening hymn Where He Leads, the words on the screen, or hymn number 338.
Follow me where he leads.
At this time, I would like to invite the children to come up and join me on the steps. And through the miracle of technology, we're going to see Miss Clarissa give us a children's moment.
Days. So I can't be here today, but I want to talk to the kids a little bit today about my toolbox that I took with me. Can you help me look through here? And we'll just look at my tools and just talk about what we find. Okay, so what do we got here? A hammer
and a screwdriver.
Those are totally normal tools. Totally normal tools in my totally normal toolbox, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, now we have a spatula and a whisk, also normal tools for a normal toolbox, right? No, I'm sure someone's got these in a toolbox somewhere. Okay, we'll talk about it. Well, let's see what else is in here. Ooh, we have a bell, like a nice little musical instrument. Totally normal for a toolbox, right?
I don't think so.
No, what else we got in here? Oh, we got a Bible. Is that normal for a toolbox? Good for a toolbox, maybe?
Yeah,
okay.
I think so.
Maybe not normal, but maybe good for a toolbox?
Yeah, good for a toolbox.
All right, what else do we got? A frisbee. Everybody's got one of these in their toolboxes, right?
No.
No?
No.
Maybe they should.
No.
Let's see what else we got. Ha ha.
A first aid kit.
First aid kit.
You should always have one of those in your toolbox.
We should. Do you think everybody does?
I think they should.
They
but
should.
I don't know if people do.
Maybe not quite normal. Well, let's see what else we got. A pin cushion. You have one of these in your toolbox, right?
No.
Are you sure? This is pretty normal.
No.
No? Okay. Well, let's see what else we got in here. Work gloves. That's a normal toolbox thing, right?
Yeah. Except they are winter gloves.
Oh, they're work gloves. Okay. What else do we have?
They're sponsored by Pepsi.
Yep. Oh, and then we have a greeting card. A greeting card that you wrote me. That's normal for a toolbox, right?
No.
Does everybody have toolboxes from their loved ones in their toolbox? Greeting cards in their toolbox?
Some people might.
Might? Okay, so I have a confession. There were three other men on the crew that I helped with, and they had enough tools for probably 8 projects worth, so I didn't actually bring any tools. What does this toolbox actually say?
It says the church.
So it says the church. So I brought this toolbox today to kind of talk about if this toolbox were to represent our church. So, the normal tools that you said go in a toolbox, our hammer and our screwdriver, this represent the people that we think of when we think of church. So Pastor Steve, we think of people in the office maybe, the people that lead worship and make things happen. This is our normal tools in our normal toolbox, right? So that's our normal church things. But we have so much more in our church. We have so many people that have so many gifts, and they all contribute together to make a beautiful thing. So we have two wonderful kitchen facilities, and we have people there that are really gifted at cooking and fixing meals for people in our church, for people in our community, like our community dinners, for our senior lunches, all the different things that we provide food for our community.
And just to like for the older people, we deliver it for the other people.
Exactly, just like for a community dinner, we deliver meals. That's great.
Because I helped with that one.
You did, and it's great, and we love for everybody to come help us.
And when the younger ones, when they get a little bit older, like my age, they'll be able to help. Too.
Exactly. We hope everybody can come eat and come help. So we have work gloves. So this represents, we have people that take care of our church building. They're called our trustees, and they might not get up and talk or lead singing, but they go and they help take care of our building if something's broken. These are the people that help take care of it and help keep things nice so we can come here and worship together. Isn't that great? Mm-hmm. So we have people with that kind of gift.
And custodians.
And our custodians,
which,
exactly.
like clean the floors if there are trash on the floor.
Exactly. So big thank you to them.
And they take out the trash so the church doesn't get stinky.
Exactly. So we have our first aid kit, which we said was good for a normal toolbox, but also represents, we have some people in our church that are really, really good in the community. They're doctors or nurses or paramedics, and they help take care of people, and they help take care of in the community, but also in our church. And it's really good that they have that sort of gift. They can help our church.
Yes, they do.
So what is this? This is our bell. So this represents all the people in our church that are greatly talented. So are people that play piano or organ or sing on Sundays or sing at Christmas or Easter or in the choir, or that play in our bell choir, or any of our special music. So they might not be the ones doing the sermon, but they add a whole lot to our church, right? Wouldn't be complete without our music, right?
And our teacher here, she's also sang a couple of times.
Mm-hmm, a couple times, huh? What about this? You said this was not normal for our toolbox, right?
Yeah, because you knit like clothes with it sometimes.
So this is a pin cushion, and we have people in our community, or in our church, that are super crafty. So they make some of our banners that you see around the church at different times, or they do our craft show. Yep.
And they paint like the paintings in the hallway to the.
Yeah, we have all in the hallway out there. We have lots of people in our church that help to make that, and it's beautiful and it's crafty. So we have people that work with their hands and take care of the building, but we also have people in our church that help make it beautiful. So this
is a Bible.
It's a Bible, and it's a small Bible. So this represents our Sunday school teachers and our preschool teachers. So these are the people that they might not be up here leading big sermons, but we also need them because we need kids to learn about God, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we need people that are specially gifted to help teach those classes. And our junior church and our children's moments, there are so many people that have so many gifts in our church, and we all need to work together. What is this?
It's my Frisbee.
It's a Frisbee. So this represents all of the fun things that we do, like our youth group or our open gyms that we host, or anything that we host that's really fun.
Like work camp.
So this, there's lots of people in our church that are really good at doing fun things. And they can do fun things for our church, and we can also use that to outreach to our community. And then what's our last thing?
The last thing is a greeting card.
This is a greeting card. We have a group at our church called the Dare to Care Team, and they write letters to people in our church throughout the whole year, just saying, hi, I'm thinking of you, we're praying for you, we're happy to have you around. And those people might also aren't the ones getting up leading sermons, but they are so special. And this toolbox right here, this church, would not be complete without all of these people with all of these different gifts. Isn't that great?
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus is the one that helps us all use our gifts and all work together.
And just thank you to our church for being such nice people.
Exactly. Thank you to our church. And we also need to remember that we need Jesus for this. So we all need to remember to invite him into our hearts. So as we close today with a song, I want you to think about how we can all use our gifts to work together and let Jesus use us to our full potential. Can you sing with me? Into my heart, into my heart, come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come in today, come in to stay. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Thank you guys, and I hope you enjoy the rest of Work Camp Sunday.
You guys may head back to your church. At this time, we are blessed to have Pastor Steve share some special music with us.
Amen.
Thank you, Steve.
At this time, we come to our time of prayer. In your bulletin, you will see a prayer list. There are some new names on it this week. There are names and things that are unspoken on that prayer list and in our own hearts. We're going to take a moment of silence here in just a moment to lift all of those needs, concerns, and praises to the throne of God, to leave them and share them with our Creator. Let's take a moment of silence to lift up those prayer concerns, spoken and unspoken, for a moment. Good morning, Heavenly Father. We come this morning as a people who have questions and concerns in a chaotic world. We strive to find the answers of what we should do as a church. We struggle on our own to understand what we should do, and we fall short. Help us return to the foot of your throne, knowing you are in total control. We lay our earthly concerns of health, despair, and uncertainty at your feet. Help us remember that you know our every need. As the songwriter penned, his eye is on the sparrow, so I know he watches me. Help us be your church that boldly moves into the world to serve and to share the good news of the gospel. You are our friend and our guide through these troubled times. And you sent your Son Jesus to show us the perfect way to talk with you as our friend. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, I'm going to ask one of our youth to come up and share this morning's scripture. There are two scriptures, one from Psalms and one from the Gospel of John.
Psalm 119:74. May all who fear you find in me a cause for joy, for I have put my hope in your word. John 1:14. So the word became human and made his home among us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness, and we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's one and only Son.
During our week of work camp, it's amazing to watch the growth of our youth and some of our adults as well. Some of us haven't grown up yet, but it's still amazing to see that. And we're going to take this opportunity to have some of our youth from both churches share their experiences and their thoughts from the week that we were in Ironton. And at this time, I think we will start with Miss Samantha Jewell.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, so for those of you who don't know me, my name is Samantha Jewell. I've been attending this church for about 11 years. I've gotten to know each and every one of you, most of you, and it's a great experience here. I love this church. So I've been going to work camp for about 3 years, and it's always an amazing experience, but this year has every experience that I've ever gone to beat. So normally going into work camp, we're always like super quiet and no one ever talks because we're all like, I don't know you. But we all like bonded immediately and we all became best friends. This year I was working on a ramp site. The lady we were working for, her name was Pat. This was really special to me because she had us call her Nana. And a few years back, my Nana passed away from lung cancer. And she's just so sweet and welcoming, and she looked exactly like my Nana, and I just thought, wow, God's really just brought her into my life and given her to me and just blessed me with that experience. But on the first day we started working, it was about 90 degrees, if not hotter. Nana was super sweet, and she came out and gave everyone popsicles, which she didn't have to do. So we started working, and at the end of the day, we were all finished for the day, and we went back to the church and immediately just got together, bonded, and after that, we just played some games and went to bed, couldn't wait for the next day. The next day, we went to work and continue on the ramp. On the second day, she made us muffins for breakfast. And on the third day, she made us cookies. The final day we went, which was the final day we were working on everything, we completed it that day. It was her birthday, her birthday was the next day. So we brought her a cake and we all sang to her and just spent the day with her, which was super amazing because, you know, bonding with that just, it's special. It doesn't happen very often, especially coming into someone you don't know and them being as sweet as she was. It's just amazing. So that's all I have. Thank you.
The work is important, but that's not everything that we do while we're there. Our next speaker this morning will be Allie Helsel.
So the first day, I learned how to use a jigsaw, and when we were making COVID shields for the food pantry, so they could finally move their food pantry back inside. They had to have it outside for a while because they didn't have like the safety equipment for like COVID that they needed. So we went and we built some COVID shields for them, so they were able to move it back inside. The next day, they got to put the COVID shields to work while we passed out some food to the community, families, so that was pretty cool. So third day of work camp, it was like a little different this year for me. I wasn't on just one site, I moved from different sites. So on the third day, I went and helped with one of the ramp sites, and we helped put like the siding and the like railing parts of that ramp up. So that was a pretty cool experience, being able to like see the different sites. And so the last day, we went and picked up a lot of wood from Lowe's because the Lowe's trucks weren't working, so we were needed to take it to another site that another group was gonna come down and work with them. And build a different ramp for another family. So we got to take the wood to that site and just be able to like help with the starting of that next group coming in. So that was a lot of fun. And I just love being able to grow closer to God every night we had a lesson that was led by a youth, which was followed by family groups. I like that during the family groups, we reflected on our day and learned about others' experiences that happened throughout the day or week. I also thought it was really cool being able to see all the teamwork and just people wanting and thriving just to help other people. So I would like to thank everybody that was supporting us while we were down there and all the adults that were down there helping us go through the sites. So. And I'm looking forward to years to come. So thank you.
COVID, as we all know, played havoc with us last year and left a lot of things uncertain. We weren't sure until a few months ago that work camp was going to happen. And then as a part of that, we weren't sure what we were going to find when we got down there as far as materials and cost. I just want to take this time to thank this congregation. Your generosity, your sharing monetarily was overwhelming. Our ramp sites this year doubled in cost as far as materials. And we weren't sure how that was going to go as far as our funding. You, over and above, pressed down and overflowing, you provided that for us. And again, from my heart, I want to thank you because this is a ministry that is near and dear to my heart, and it obviously means a great deal to you as well with your support. So again, I want to thank you for that. Also during COVID, things happen, and during work camp, things happen that we were not expecting. I'm going to ask Scott Helsel to come forward. We had a situation that we were not aware of till we went down to look at sites that came up, and we are going to take another small group later this summer. But I'd like Scott to share that with you.
Hi, I'm Scott. So as Wade mentioned, gentleman that we met down there, he helps us out, kind of guiding us around the community, helping us find stuff. His name is Mike, and he made us aware of a family that had experienced a huge tragedy. Their son, 18-year-old Vincent Kearns, was in a ATV accident, and had suffered a traumatic brain injury. And he asked if there was any way we could get that work, help the family with the project they needed done, if we could work that in on work camp. Unfortunately, the scope and complexity of it prevented us from doing that, but we were able to go meet with Vincent's sister. We all thought she was in her 20s, the way she carried herself, and this young lady was 16 years old. I don't know whether she was this mature before the accident or whether this has caused her to grow up, but her and her mom are taking care of Vincent at home. They bathe him, they do everything for him, get him back and forth to Columbus multiple times a week to Children's, and the one issue that they're struggling with is their shower. They have to lift him and the wheelchair into the shower over this about 6-inch lip. And that's a struggle for both of them. So we're going to go down and help them out with this. When we met them, and we went down a couple weeks before work camp to look at sites and kind of get a game plan together. We walked out of that house and we just kind of looked at each other like, we got to do something. For a few of us, this hit really close to home. You may remember 2 years ago, we asked for prayers for a friend of ours, Tristan Boring, over in Thornville. And he had been in a very similar accident, traumatic brain injury. That first week, he was not expected to live. by the grace of God, Tristan is back out on the farm helping his dad and his uncle. And every time we pass him in town driving one of those tractors, I just can't help but know that miracles do happen. And Tristan is living proof of that. We shared that story with Vincent's mom, Dana, and his sister. Tristan had a long road. Vincent's got a long road. Miracles can happen and will happen. They need your prayers. There's just an endless list of what they need. But these two women, mother and daughter, are doing the best they can to care for their son, brother, and the community has been awesome rallying around them. But later this summer, we're working with their schedule and ours to try to work things out. Vincent has had some complications in the last couple weeks. So it's created some issues with scheduling and everything, but we're gonna go down and get that shower taken out, the one that's there, put a new one in, and hopefully make their life a little easier. I would ask that you pray for them. Pray for Vincent, pray for his mom Dana, sister Victoria, and just thank you so much for all the support you guys provide. Like Wade said, materials are just through the roof, and work camp can't happen without your support. And it really does change these children's lives, and us adults too. And we appreciate everything you guys do. So thank you.
At this time, I'm gonna ask Jeff Seeds, who is the youth leader at Summit Station, to come forward, and he's got a couple of his youth that wanna speak, and then he's got some words to say as well.
Well, I'm thrilled to be back here. This is our sixth year. I think we've been doing this together, and it's been powerful every single year. And this year, maybe I just can't remember real well the past years, but this was an amazing year. So the first speaker I'd like to introduce is our recent high school graduate, and she's got a servant's heart. And she was also, Ellie mentioned we had youth speakers every evening. And Amelia Zola was one of those speakers. So, Amelia.
Hello, how y'all doing? So I went to work camp this year with the church, and it was good. It was a really great experience. I learned a lot about God. I learned a lot about the people that I was around. I learned how much this church had an influence in us going, like with the prayers and with like helping out financially. I didn't realize how expensive it was to build a ramp until we had to keep on going back to home to get like more supplies. But I want to thank you guys for that. This work camp experience has taught me a lot. We're from the city, like Jeff and I, Bible study, we're from the city. We've never really met people like you guys. So when we came to work camp, sorry, it's a good thing. When we came to work camp, I didn't know what to expect, how the people like would, like the people that we would be serving with would take us in. But I was definitely, you know, blown away by how everybody was treating us. Like Scott, I mean, Amy was so good. Like she's like a mom now. Like she was like everybody's mom. Scott is so kind. He is so kind. He was so patient with all of us because on our work site, I think it was me, Destiny, Casey Johnson and Thomas. We were doing a lot of the work, and I'm very inexperienced when it comes to like work stuff, but they were being very patient with all of us, very kind. I've never like had such like kindness and hospitality, and I think that's due to the prayers, obviously, by the church family. And it's just like when I think about work camp, I just think about it like is as a dream. Like it didn't feel real. Like every day it felt unreal how much love there was around us and how much we were just serving. Like not everything was about us. We were doing things that was like out of our comfort zone, things that was our first times doing. Like, it was like the first time for, I think, Destiny to speak, like, and her testimony about staying perseverant was very powerful. It was just a first time for a lot of us to do anything, and it was just a really great experience. It reminded me, like, the church in Acts 2, how they were all worshiping God when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, and how they were just serving God. But yeah, that was my work camp experience.
Our next speaker is one of our college students, has also a servant's heart and also a gift of ministry, and it's Jonathan Kalala.
Sorry. Hey guys, I'm Jonathan. I'm very known for speaking very fast, so I'm gonna try the best I can to slow it down as possible. So, I met Jeff last year, and that's how long I've been attending Summit Bible Study sessions. And he asked me to play the piano for one of the nights. And it was Thursday night, and I said, why not? But I showed up for the whole week, Monday to Friday. The thing with that is, on Monday, as I was just playing along with the piano, some of my friends came along, and we were just playing around with them and stuff like that. And the idea came, what are we singing tonight? And I was like, why not? So as we were practicing, we ended up performing that night, per se. And so was every night during the work camp. With that is, the ones that were singing never sang before, don't have any experience like being on stage and stuff like that. But it was just powerful seeing how one night worship turned into a whole week worship. And there were some nights that we barely practiced. We just showed up for like 30 minutes and we did not do anything. But like once we got to the worshiping part, the spirit was always moving. And that was just very powerful. So that's my work camp experience.
Yeah, it's just one of the surprises God always lays out for us. As we really only had music planned for Thursday night, and then Jonathan and some of the students got together and said, why not music every night? And so, as Jonathan just laid out, it was powerful music every single night, and that led right into the speakers. And so it was just amazing worship every single evening. I thought I would go ahead and share a little bit more about how God really worked in a way that he always surprises us. But the thing that was amazing is when we start, you heard Grace earlier here read our two scriptures. And in the scriptures talk heavily about Jesus being the Word. And our first night, we asked the students, because we've got these scriptures on the back of our shirts. If someone comes up and asks you about them, are you ready to answer the questions? And so basically our first question is, who is the Word? And right out of the gate, we had a youth immediately say, I'm the Word. And it's like, wow, okay. So how do you justify that? Why do you say that? And it's because those of us that has allowed Jesus to dwell in us are the Word, because we reflect him. And so that was powerful, and just having that laid out right in front of us at the very first night we were there. Wade got up and also spoke about hope and how he mentioned it here today too, about how we are living in a very difficult time, especially the past couple years. And we are that hope because Jesus is in us to deliver that hope. And so what I thought we would do is, this is a picture of Nana, and you heard Samantha already talk about her. And it was a powerful experience when we built a ramp, but as we also heard, the ramp really isn't why we're there. And as we looked, and this hug, we see a hug, and that's Jacob giving Nana a hug. Now she hugged everybody, right, and fed us every day, but you can see that hug. But I want you to understand that hug, because the hug is not for the ramp. She I've got a card here that she wrote, and to us, and it said to Jacksonary Ministries, and it named a couple of leaders and all the kids, and then it says, thank you for all you've done in building my ramp, but thank you for the kindness and caring. And then I so enjoyed getting to know each one of you. And she was like, she knew each one of us. She was hugging up kids, be spending the time on her porch in front of that, and the kids were swarming her all the time. It was amazing to watch that. I don't know if it was Samantha, when they made birthday cards, encouragement cards, the kids did their own artwork back at the church and took them with them to her, right? And she says, good luck in the future and in all you do. And then she signs it Nana. But there's a line I want to share with you guys that was like right before this or right after, I can't remember. And she says, Jeff, you don't have any idea what you've just done, right? You don't have any idea. And it's like, well, Nana, we're just so thankful you allowed us to come here and work on your property and build this ramp. And she goes, no, you don't know what you've done. And then she said, you know, she used to be involved with the youth a lot, and I think coached tennis or was supportive in the tennis program for youth, and she loved hanging out with the youth. And here she is, she got to spend the whole week with a group of young people, which is just amazing, right? But it's because these young people have got Jesus within them. That's the hugging that's going on right there. It's the hugging not only from the youth, but also just the love of Jesus shining through us. Now here's this hug. The important thing about this hug is it goes way beyond just those of us that are there. It's all you. She's hugging all of you because she's hugging Jesus, right? Anyways, your church, our church, we're all the church wherever we're at. And just thanks for everything you do and have done, the prayers, and this is the result you see that. You heard one of our, Amelia talking about work camp was like an Acts 2 church. That's what's going on at work camp. It's powerful, and God moves. Thank you.
You've heard the words. Now let's watch some of the pictures that were involved in that week. Thank you. That last picture took a lot of practice to get that posed that way. I didn't have any idea that was in there, and boy, what a surprise that is. At this time, I would ask that we stand for our closing hymn as we close this very special day. It is hymn number 593, and the words will be on the screen or in your hymnals. Before I ask Pastor Steve to send us forth with the benediction, throughout this whole service, this hour of worship, we have seen and heard that the church is our opportunity to share the good news of the gospel. Let us be the church, all of us, be the church of Jesus Christ in this troubled world.
Friends, it is true. I am the church. You are the church. We are the church together. All who follow Jesus, all around the world, yes, we are the church together. Go in the blessing of Jesus Christ, whom you have seen and heard and felt, and can give testimony that indeed is real and true. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may God be with all of us. Amen.